more minute on your warm up. What do you think about it? Give me a thumbs up if you think you got it. Sideways, it was okay. Thumbs down, I just don't get it. Quickly, 5, 4, 3, 2, just slide it. And 1, just slide. All right, I'm so excited for today because we're gonna continue with algebra. You know, on last year we did a lot of algebra and we're gonna continue to do that again this year. What we're looking at today is we're going to be combining like terms. So on today, we're going to be combining like terms. So on the count of three, the learner, I will simplify expressions by combining like terms. 1, 2, 3, I will.
I will simplify expressions by combining like terms.
Awesome. How many of you remember like terms from sixth grade? And I excel, all that I excel work that we did on like terms. As a group, come up with some categories. So that means you know what we're doing today. We're going to be combining like terms, but before we get started, I want to see what you know. I want you in your groups, I'm going to give you about 6 minutes to come up with whatever category that your group can come up with, and then we're going to share out. Put those cards into categories. Whatever you think, whatever comes to mind. Good. I hear somebody talking about decimals in this group. What are y'all thinking of these? Okay. Cool. All right, that's great. Now this, so you have all of the whole numbers over here in decimals?
Yes,
all right, cool. Now help Skylar with his category. Awesome. So now we're gonna share out, okay? We're gonna share out what our categories were. All right, this group, since no one wants to raise their hand. Okay, Ayak, tell me some of your categories. How did you categorize a group, the cards that were found in the packet with no instruction? I just told you to categorize them. What did you guys come up with?
We did positive numbers and
so you have four groups. So they had positive, a group that was just positive numbers. Then you had groups that contained all negative numbers. And then you had, what were your variable groups?
Y and X.
So you had a Y group and an X group. Did anyone else have something similar to this? Just positives? Just negatives? A group just that contains only Y variables and a group that contains X variables. Who had that? Something similar? Okay, put your hands up. Last group, what did you guys come up with? Y'all had plenty of groups. Can you tell us about
them? One group was the Y group.
So we had a Y group. Okay, awesome.
X group.
Okay, we had another X group. Awesome.
We had the decimal group.
Okay, y'all had decimals. Okay, we had that. Awesome.
We had a negative group.
A negative group? Yes.
And we had a positive whole number.
Awesome. A positive whole number group. Awesome, you guys. You did great. Okay? So can I tell you the secret? What the secret was with the activity? It really wasn't a secret, okay? But it was all about combining like terms. You could have had a group with all of the Y's. Anything that had a Y variable behind it would have been in a group, okay? So, y'all come up quickly. Y'all come see. Let me show you. You could have had a Y group. Come on, everybody. Y'all know we get up. Come on. All right, so let's look at these groups, all right? So you could have had a X group, all right? Now notice in the X group, do we have any negative numbers in this particular group? Negative integers or rational numbers? Do we have negatives in this group?
Yes.
Okay, do we have decimals in this group?
Yes.
Okay, do we have whole numbers in this group?
Yes.
Fractions in this group?
Yes.
But what do they all have in common?
They have a variable X.
Does anyone know what this means? Why is this group so special? It's a special name for this group. Who can remember from last year?
They have the same family.
They all are in the same family. But what is the mathematical term for that? All in the same family.
Like terms?
They are all like terms, regardless if you have a negative, a decimal, or any of that, or a fraction, they're still like terms because they all have the same last name. Very good. Let's look at this group. Why is this a family?
They all have the same variable.
They all have the same variable. Their variable of Y. So we can add, subtract, whatever with this group. Same thing with this group. Now, let's look at this. Should we separate these groups into positives and negatives?
Yep.
Should they be separate or should we bring them together?
Bring them together.
Why can we bring them together?
Because they're like terms.
Why are they like terms? I have a positive and I have a negative.
But they don't have variables.
Very good. What do we call these types of numbers collectively?
Whole numbers.
You have some whole numbers. Okay?
Decimals.
And you have negative numbers. You have decimals and fractions. So all of these, if you will put this all into a group, they're rational numbers. Anybody remember what rational numbers
are? Any whole number or decimal that repeats itself.
Okay, that can repeat itself. So anything that can be written as a fraction. Remember from earlier this year? Awesome. Give you 5 seconds to go back in your group and put those together. Awesome, you guys. Good job. Okay, so let's continue on. We had our warm-up. We had our opening. And now we're going to do an I do. A we do and a you do, we'll have our closure and exit ticket. Any questions so far on that sorting activity? Go ahead and put it away and put it in your bin. All right, so let's review the vocabulary for this particular lesson, all right? Remember what we're going to be doing today, simplifying expressions using like terms. I need someone in the group to pass out the notes, okay? As we go through the slide, I need you to take your notes. Now, this is... If anything trips you up on this lesson, it will be the terms, okay? And remember that terms are separated by a minus sign or a plus sign, or you can think of it as a negative or a positive. So to separate the terms, remember last year, we would go ahead and we would put those lines in front of the operations, and that will tell us how many terms we have, okay? So terms are separated by operations. So we know that there are how many terms, class?
Three.
Three terms. Very, very good. How many terms, class? I want you to think first. How many terms do we have and how do we know? Think about it. How many terms? Good. All right. Do we have two terms?
No.
Okay. How many terms do we have?
Four.
Four. And how can I guarantee, how do I know for sure? What can I do? What's that thing that we learned on last year?
You can separate it
by drawing a line. Okay, very, very good. So what are my four terms?
3x,
3/4y,
-2
and 4/10x,
and
+4. Very, very good. What are my coefficients? Coefficients. What are the coefficients? You look back at your notes. Very good, Azarian. What are your coefficients? Good. Class, what are the coefficients?
A.
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 Stop.
No,
right. Think about it.
It's
somebody said X.
No.
What is X?
That's the variable.
That's the variable. What's X destiny?
A
Okay, what's the coefficient? It comes in front of the?
Variable.
So what's the variable?
Three.
I mean, not the variable, the coefficient.
Three.
Okay?
Three-fourths.
Positive three-fourths.
Negative two-fourths.
All right. Be a little challenged, but we can get through it. You should have notes, so here we go. You ready to combine like terms? All right, here we go. What I need you to get is in your basket, you need an index card and some scissors. Quickly, 5 seconds. Everybody needs one index card. I love this. Y'all know algebra is my favorite, right?
Yes.
Now, you're going to have to know your integer rules. Please make me proud, all right? So, what happens with this particular skill is the same skill from last year, but we just added negatives. You already know your integer rules. If you need a reference, please look in the back at our anchor chart. A lot of students get confused with this, okay? And why do you think some of them might get confused with this particular skill? What are some errors that you think a student might make with these types of problems? AAC. Okay, that's enough on like terms. Very good. What's another mistake a student might make with these types of problems? Emily.
They might not put the negative in front of negative 14.
Yes, very good. Not bringing over those negatives. Awesome. Amira, what else?
No, I'm going to say add and subtract.
Not knowing your integer rules or not bringing that negative or positive over to know whether you need to add or subtract. Destiny.
They could add the wrong two. Variables like 2y and 14x.
So not knowing what like terms are. The most common problem I see with this, people do not, so say they have, no, 14x and 4x are like terms, but they don't bring the negative with it, all right? So the first thing we're going to do is this. On your note card, you're going to write this particular problem down quickly. So this is, I'm going to model it. 2y minus 14x plus 5 minus 4x plus 2.5. We're going to draw our lines. And why do we draw our lines?
So you can know when, is it positive or negative?
That's right. To know if it's going to be positive or negative. Okay? Next thing we're going to do is we're going to take our scissors. And we're going to cut along those lines. Because I'm proving to you that in order to move your terms, you have to bring the sign that is in front of it. Are you with me? You can't move the term without bringing the sign that is attached to it. Is that clear? All right. You have to move the sign. If you don't move the sign, 9 times out of 10, your problem is going to be wrong. My like terms are negative 14x and negative 6x. And I'm going to put one line in front of them. I know they're like terms because they have the same last name. They both have an x. Does it matter about the coefficient? No. The coefficient could have been a fraction. It could have been a decimal. It doesn't matter. It's not about the coefficient. It's about the variable. They have the same last name. I also know that these two are like terms, okay? They're like terms because they're rational numbers. They don't have a variable behind it, so I know that they don't belong into any family. And OY, he doesn't have any family here at the party, okay? He can't join the party. He doesn't have any family. Okay, so now it's that I've identified my like terms, now it's time to combine them. My first step is going to be, I know 2y is by itself. Does that make sense to you? Yes. 2y is lonely, he's by himself. You with me?
Yes,
ma'am. All right. Next, we're going to take the 14x and the negative 4x, because they're like terms. With me?
Yes, ma'am.
And then our last two. And they're like terms. So now I have my like terms together. So now it's just time for me to simplify, okay? So my answer will be 2y, okay? Now, let's look at this one. If you just take away the x's, you would have negative 14 minus 4. Does everybody see where I get that from? Yes. Negative 14 minus 4. And I know with that, that's a subtraction problem, so I have to keep
change.
So that'll be negative 14 plus
4.
Negative 4. Okay? And that will give me a negative 18x. So what did I get when I combined negative 14x and minus 4x? What did I get?
Negative 18x.
So I'm just going to add that to my 2y. Here's my negative 18x. And I'm almost done. The last piece that I need to do is 5 plus 2.5. Okay? And I know that's a whole number plus a decimal, and I have to line it up for you visual folks like me. And I know that is going to be a positive 7.5. Now my answer is simplified because I don't have any more like terms to combine. You're going to do a think, pair, share. I want you to use the same process that I did. Use your index cards to solve the problem. Okay? I'm going to give you 5 minutes to do this one. Good job. Okay, why did you do that? What's this? What did you do?
I changed the fraction to the decimal.
Awesome. Very, very good. Awesome. All right. So, what did we learn today? Think about it first. What did we learn today? Okay? And how was it different from last year? What did we learn today, and how was it different from last year? Azarin. What did we learn today, and how was it different from last year?
We learned to combine my terms, to be a woman is different.
So he said we learn how to combine like terms. Who can tell me the difference from this year and last year? What's the difference? Sam, can you help me? What's the difference? It's the same, but it's something different. Hey, yeah. Oh yeah, y'all are fluent, but it's one key thing.
Now we use fractions and decimals.
Very good. That's what you're gonna say, Emily? Very, very good. Now, what is a helpful hint? Imagine if a student was absent. He wasn't here today. What advice could you help him with or give him for this lesson? What advice could you give an absent student for combining like terms? What advice could you give a student, an absent student, that might help him with this particular lesson? Emily.
I would probably tell them that it was kind of like the same thing, but just with fractions.
Anybody else want to give advice? Awesome.
Yes. You explain coefficients, constants, and terms.
Okay, you would explain coefficients, constants, and terms. Okay, on your board, here's our smiley face poster. I got it. Almost there, Haston. Just don't get it. On the count of three. And I know how y'all get with these smiley faces, so quickly, just give me one. Okay? One. Two, three. Let me see your smiling face or whatever you have. Okay, I have some. I got it. Okay, I see one. I'm almost there, Haston. All right. Scott, you don't have that. That's okay. So, we don't have any that say we just don't get it. All right. Let's clean our stations, and now it's time for our exit. You guys did great today. And you know when you finish the exit ticket, it goes in the bucket in the front of the room.